Hi guys, want to make this message for Christians and those who seek God, who don't know God. And the question today, the topic I want to discuss today will be, how do you know that Jesus is real? Guys, how do you know? Very simple, obey Jesus Christ. Believe in Him and obey Him. Jesus said that he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. So Jesus promised that he will manifest himself to you if you keep his commandments, if you do things which he said, if you believe in him. So you say, yeah, but I need to first believe. Guys, you can have a seed, a faith of a mustard seed, you know, and that's enough. Even you have a little faith, just ask God to give you more faith. You know, ask God in the name of Jesus Christ to give you more faith and apply His words. Pray all the time, apply His words. And then, how do I know Jesus is real? Because He reveals Himself to me. You know, He reveals Himself to me. And if you want Him to reveal Himself to you, you need to start working for Him. You need to start doing the things which He's told to do, to preach the gospel, to live the gospel first of all, and then to preach it. And how do I know Jesus is real? Because the Holy Spirit tells us of the things to come. You know, Jesus often warns me beforehand what is coming. You know, exactly. He shows it me in Scripture. He shows me where to open the Scripture, where to look at, and what to look at. And, you know, He gives me numbers of Psalms to read, and I read them, and it's the exact same things which are to come right now, and then they happen, and I know because Jesus just warned me, you know. And then I preach, you know, I street preach also, guys. And you know, when I pray, it's not, I'm not magnifying here, I'm nothing, guys. The lower we are, the better it is, because the more Jesus can manifest through us. But you know, when you go and when you preach the gospel, when you street preach, you know, you'll see things like unexplainable, like people who doubt. You know, their beers falling from their hands, you know, and exploding and just splashing all their bodies in this foam of beer, you know, and they say, wow, was that a sign? You know, other people stumble on the flat ground, you know, and fall on their knees, you know, and you preach to them, you know, you hand them out the flyer. And that's God, it's His providence. And, you know, Jesus manifests Himself to you. He will show you His reality, how it's unexplainable. He will have His personal way with you, you know. He has His personal way with me. And but you will know that you know that He is real if you get serious to Him. Many people are not serious, but guys, you know, when I had little faith, I decided to myself that the gospel of Jesus Christ is so beautiful that it gives sense to this life. I even thought that, but I had the Holy Spirit inside of me confirming me that that it is truth. But I thought even back then that you know, that if not for this gospel, this life would be meaningless here. No, this gospel gives meaning to life, and it is true, guys. And the Holy Spirit confirms it, and you will know it later. You know, and the longer you walk with Jesus Christ, the more you know that He is real, because He manifests Himself to you. He sets you free from sin. That's the biggest. Like testimony, you know, like you were a sinner, you had some battles, and he teaches you to pray, to receive the power from Him and to apply it, and you walk in this power, guys. And you know, I'm not here glorifying myself, guys. It's any serious believer, anyone who takes Jesus seriously. And Jesus knows, you know, He knows how much time do you devote to Him. He knows that, you know, we have to love Him with all our heart. That's the standard, all. It means that if He tells you to change something in your life, that you do that, you know, and you work for Him, you know, that His priorities of the kingdom of God should be most important to you, not your own ideas, but His ideas, His plans. You know, all people are going to hell, and for Him, most important thing is to set people free from slavery to sin, and to bring them to Jesus Christ so they can enter heaven, you know, so they don't have to go to hell. And if you stop living focused on yourself, self-centered, and start living Christ-centered. You know, Lord, what is it today you want me to do for you? What is it today? You know, he will manifest himself to you tremendously. The reason why people don't see Jesus and don't feel him is because they still want to live like they want to live and just God to help them. That won't work, guys. You bring your life to altar, to him, you know, not to church altar. You bring it to his feet. That's what I mean. That's where your life should be, at his feet. And he will tell you what to do with it. If that's the attitude with you, if you're ready to work for him, if you're ready to lose your friends for him, if you're ready to feel stupid for him, if you're ready, I mean, it's not that you'll feel stupid, but people will think that you're stupid. You'll feel honored because you work for the King of Kings and Lords of Lords. And, you know, he trains you. He doesn't, you know, with me, he didn't ask from me right away, like from day one to just go street preach. You know, he built myself into it. But thing is that, guys, if you're not serious to Jesus, you will never know him. If you're serious to him, he will show himself to you. He will send you dreams, visions. He will call you to fast. He'll call you to testify to people, to witness to people. He'll burn out all the bad things from you. He will chastise you and correct you. Oh, guys, I have been chastised and corrected. And thanks the Lord for him. Now, every day, I thank him for everything good and, I mean, pleasing and unpleasing, which I had in my life. Because from him, since I came to him, everything was good in my life. Everything, you know, because even when it hurt me in the past, even when I didn't understand something in the past, now I can see a lot of things clearly. Before, it didn't make sense. Now I understand it. God is after reshaping you. God is after making you into the image of his son, Jesus Christ. God is into remolding your values, your priorities. You know, you want situation around you to change. And God wants, first of all, to change you. And when you will be changed, maybe he changes your situation also. But he wants to make you fruitful, to make you usable. And, you know, some of us, when we're not broken, we cannot be used. We don't want to break. We want to save our life. But Jesus says that those who will want to save their lives, they will lose them. Those who lose their lives for my sake, they will save them, or something like that. So that's the point, guys. And we all think, yeah, well, we don't want to save our lives, but still, it's not what you think and what you say, it's how you act, you know, and how you live it. And the thing is that Jesus helps you, well, you know, when you pray, when you read the gospel and debate, he helps you to realize, the longer you go with him, that everything he said is real. Everything. Absolutely everything. And the more I walk with him, the more fully and deeper I realize it. Is that if he tells you that you have to deny yourself daily and seek his kingdom and his righteousness, he means it. You wake up, you don't go doing your own things. You wake up, you pray. Then you seek his will for today. Then you go do his will. And when he gives this all parables with the storms and the boats, and you know, and this, you will have this, and he will teach you more and more to trust him, you know, and he will also teach you to show you your own foolishness. It's when you have not faith, but you have foolishness, like you think God will do this when he never promised you this, and you say, yeah, he will do this, he will do that, and he doesn't do this, and he shows you where is faith and where is your stupidity. I'm not trying to be cruel, guys. It's just something he teaches, you know. He also teaches you his ways. He shows you what is important for him and what is not important, and he will show you what things in your life are important and what things in your life you think are important, which are not important. And he will teach you to trust him, and he will show you that all his ways are good, and even when it doesn't make sense to you, even when it hurts, you know, and there will be such moments, guys. But Jesus will reveal himself to you. And I suggest you guys, from the point of experience, and I already have some, I'm not telling I'm like some guru, there are many, many people who are more experienced than me, but I'm just saying that even my not such a big experience shows that You know, Jesus teaches us obedience. He teaches us utter, I would even say, violent righteousness. Violent righteousness. You know, the violent people take kingdom of heaven. You know, and he teaches us the fear of the Lord and seriousness. You know, when we come to Jesus, we're not serious. We think, oh yeah, you know, like, yeah, I believe in Jesus, but I'm still gonna do my thing. You know, Jesus will show you that either you are with him or you're doing going your own way. And if you're with him, guys, my advice to you is become 100% serious. 100% serious. Like, you know, just in all areas, in prayer, in reading the gospel, in doing his words, in seeking his voice, in holiness. Without holiness, nobody shall see God. Some people don't hear Jesus because they are not living holy. And me myself, I had these questions, why can't I hear him, you know? And now I hear him much better. And also the questions you shouldn't talk about, selfishness, get rid of that. So that's the point. May Jesus bless you guys.